part of the Conseil de Grand Cru Classé 1855 delegation that came down for the tasting to India is Damien Barton Sartorius of Chateau Leoville Barton, which a lot of people would be familiar with, and Chateau Langlois Barton. Tell me a little bit about your particular chateau and how it's different from elsewhere, because you're in Saint-Julien.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So our chateau is one of the oldest remaining in the same family, because Master and I are now the eighth generation. So Langlois Barton was bought by my sister Hugh in 1821 and Leoville in 1826, so quite some time ago. And we inherited, we took over the chateau from my mother Lillian and my grandfather Anthony. So now we are looking after these two properties that are two classified gross. So Leoville is a second classified gross, Langlois is a third classified gross. It's quite unusual to have two classified gross under a similar roof, so that's just how history has done things. And so Saint-Julien is unique in Bordeaux because it's a very small appellation. It's the surface is very small for Bordeaux, but it's very close from the river on beautiful gravel. So the power of that small size is actually the homogeneity of it, the very high quality of such a small area.
So being part of this delegation which has come from the Conseil in Bordeaux, what are you expecting in your, you said the first visit ever to India?
It is.
Yes. So we are in Bangalore today and we'll be in Hyderabad tomorrow. So what are you expecting actually out of this?
I think it's just important to spread the word about Bordeaux. Not as, of course I'm very happy about people tasting my family wines, but I think it's important through these visits to actually explain to people what is Bordeaux, place Bordeaux on the map, because Bordeaux is maybe a name people have heard of, maybe people think it's a grape variety, a country, or is it how big it is. It's very obscure and I totally understand that. So my main priority is to help people understanding, okay, this is Bordeaux, and within Bordeaux there's different faces of Bordeaux, and with the delegation we have, it's fantastic because we have different communes of Bordeaux that can represent a different, just a little glimpse of what Bordeaux can be.
And what was really interesting that I found from your presentation today is the fact that we tasted your 2012, the Langlois Barton, and it was so drinkable. And you said that you love to drink certain wines of certain vintages early. Now, this is not something everyone believes about Bordeaux, that you buy it, you store it, you keep it, you forget about it for a couple of decades, and then you bring it out for your grandchild's christening or something like that. So just let's demystify a little bit about the typical things that people believe about Bordeaux.
So
one of them being that.
So I would say there's two things that made Bordeaux wines may be more approachable younger. The first is we're always reaching for higher quality grapes. So that means whatever we pick today is just the best. Well, maybe 20, 30 years ago, we would take the whole bunch. So that means the wine was maybe didn't have the same elegance, which made they needed to wait a bit more before it started to get a bit more approachable. The wines, because they're so perfect in some ways, not in a boring way, of course, in the best way possible, are so presentable so early. But then what is very fun is that Bordeaux, because of the weather conditions, varies a lot, so the quality of the vintage varies a lot. What we call the great vintage, like would be 2005, 2010, these wines, although they're approachable today, they will be much better drinking in 20, 30 years because they're great vintage, they're really meant to age for a long time. They will just not show their full potential if you drink them early. But then there's the other vintage, and these are my personal favorite because you take so much pleasure drinking them quite early. We had the 2012, and this is still a bottle of wine that will age for another 10, 20 years if you wish, but it's already very pleasant today. And that's what I love with these, with the other vintage. So the only difficulty in that is there's a bit of education to do on the vintages, because there's no rule. There can be a whole decade like happened in 70 where there's no great vintage. And suddenly in the decade 2000, we had 2000, 2003, 2005, 2009, 2010. Five great vintage within 10 years. So it's a bit of learning, but once you get through that, I find it very exciting. It's very fun to have these different style of vintage that reflects different concentration, different typicity, different personality of wine. You can even play with food as a food pairing.
Right. So you do advise that we check vintages and not just the chateau or the region. And vintage plays an important role, because then that's where you figure out you can drink it earlier or you can drink it later.
Exactly. So the chateaus still have an important role in the sense that the more difficult vintage, a challenging vintage, some chateau will always make a good wine. Some difficult vintage, a wine might be a bit frustrating because they're not what you expect. The great names, the great chateaus, will always do a good wine on a good or a difficult vintage. And if you find a good chateau you can follow up that has a taste you agree, then once you fix the chateau, then you can play with the vintage. Whatever you pick will be good, it will just have a different personality.
Well, thank you very much, Damien.